Good morning. My name is Mike, and we are on quarantine day number, I have no idea. But if you are like anyone else, you're probably trying to work from home, and you're looking at your tiny little laptop screen, and you're like, what the hell is going on? So today, I just want to talk about working from home and how easy it can be. Now, I've worked from home since 2003 or so, like literally well over 15 years anyway, on and off here and there. And I've always made my office, well, probably the least enjoyable place in the house. And the reason I do that is because when I go into my office, I want to go there and I want to work and I want to leave when my day is done. And I don't want to have to go down there after hours and worry about stuff. I just want to go down there, work, and get out. And I set myself breaks. But that's not why you're here, because this is a tech channel. We usually talk about technology, and I want to point out a couple things. So when you are working from home, the main thing that I really want to point out to you is an external LCD screen. Now, if you have a laptop like this with a 12-inch screen, it's going to kill your eyes. Literally, that is going to, I don't care how good the resolution is, that is going to make your eyes go crazy after a while. So try and find a large LCD. Look on Facebook Marketplace, look on Kijiji, look on wherever, try and get one. This is an older Dell 24-inch. You could probably find these things for under $50. If you have to buy a new one, go to Best Buy, go to Canada Computers, go to anywhere, buy it online, have it shipped to you, and it might cost you $100 to $150 for a half-decent screen. I would aim for 22 to 24-inch. That seems to be the sweet spot. 27-inch is good, but that's awfully big when you're this close to it. I mean, you don't. It's like sitting in the front row of a movie theater. You don't want to be that close to it. When you do buy a screen like this, there are several different connections you're going to want to look for, and you want to make sure that it lines up with your laptop. So when you look at laptops, they're going to have usually one of two kind of different connections for connecting to LCDs. There's going to be the ones that will have an HDMI port, like this guy. See it right there? HDMI, same thing your TV has, and that means that it also pushes out sound, which is also nice. Or some of the older models are going to have VGA. See it right there? That's VGA. Video Graphics Array. That's what that stands for. It's older, it's analog, it does not do sound. Now, the same model also has what's known as a display port. And that can push out sound, believe it or not. And a display port cable. Let me see if I find one. That's like a little mini display port cable right there. Funky looking, I know. You're looking at that going, what is that? Well, it plugs in there, and then it pushes out to this, which looks a bit like an HDMI cable, but if you look, it's square on one side. So that's a display port. That should be able to do sound too, if your monitor or screen or whatever supports it. Keep that in mind. If you're on a desktop, desktops are usually run something like this, which is called DVI, Digital Video Interface. Yeah, Digital Video Interface. And this is usually a higher resolution cable. You won't find that in a laptop, I'll tell you that much for sure. But if your laptop is fairly new, it's gonna run HDMI, just like this one here does. And it's gonna push that signal out to the screen after a second or two. Keep in mind the laptop's not running power right now, it's just running off battery. The screen is, of course, running power. So when you're buying the screen, make sure that the connectors on the back of it connect with your laptop. All right, that's all there is to it. This will make it so much easier for your eyeballs. And if you're running, well, I use a docking system here at home, so I run two screens. I'll try and put a picture of it here. I have this screen facing this way, and then I have it also facing this way. Yeah. I haven't had a shower yet today. Don't mind the hair. Up and down, which is called portrait mode, and that is great for reading emails and stuff, because now all of a sudden your emails are, instead of being on a wide screen like this, they're on a narrow screen like this, so you can see more of it. It's also great for programming and reading stuff like the Toronto Star.
So yeah, you can see how my emails are sorted here. So that way I can actually go further in my emails and see a bit more of a brief snapshot of what they're all about. And then when I move the news over, if I just click on the star, for example, you can see that going this direction, it's going to read a bit more like a tablet newspaper. I really prefer it that way. If it was up to me, I would probably have both screens like that, but I use this one here for my spreadsheets because I go through a lot of spreadsheets. So I find the spreadsheets fit nicely on there when you can see it go so much wider. 27 inches could be okay from there if you're sitting back far enough. Like I sit back about this far. Okay, back to work. Okay, and also want to pay attention to when you right click on the screen and you go into display properties, you'll see there's a couple options here. So when you go into your dual display, you'll see right now it is extending this display. So it has the same image on monitor one as it does on monitor two. So when you click detect, well, it all thinks it's the same monitor. I go down here a little bit and I say, what would you like to do with these displays? And I would say something, for example, like I want to extend these displays. So now what that does is I'm going to go over here and say keep changes. It's now saying, okay, this is monitor number one. This is monitor number two. So when I go up here, I hit identify. See the one? There's the two. But I don't want to keep them in that order. So I'm just going to kind of drag them in the order that they are. So I put two on that side. I'll make it a little taller up like that. I'll hit apply. So now when I go to identify number one, number two, I'll watch it as I move the mouse, you'll see it pop out over here. See, it goes between the two monitors. So it's over here. Now it's over there. And now I'm going to kind of see what resolution it's running. So that one's running at 1200 display. That's number two. When I go into number one, it's running at 1080. So this is actually a higher resolution screen. And if I can try and drag it over here with only one hand, there it is. And obviously a larger screen is going to be more comfortable on your eyeballs than a smaller screen. And a higher resolution screen is going to be much more comfortable on your eyeballs than a low resolution screen, especially if this is like a 768. 1366 by 768, that becomes uncomfortable. Okay, let's get back to the rest of this video. Okay, that's what you need first. Next, you need a good chair. We won't get into the ergonomics of it. I would suggest a good chair. And I would also suggest a keyboard, because if you're typing a lot and you're doing a lot of at-home work, this is also going to make a huge difference on your wrist compared to this tiny little keyboard like that. You can see the size difference. I mean, even though they might be kind of close, you want to have that space. Lastly, get an external mouse. This will really make a difference too. And that's it. That's all there really is to working from home. That's what I would suggest. Ergonomics, take care of yourself. Get a comfortable chair, comfortable desk, find some space. Make it as unappealing as possible so that you're not going there after hours and checking stuff, and make it so there's no distractions. I would not have a TV in there. Maybe have a radio in the background or stream some sound, like stream your favorite radio station over your speakers. But I would try and make it so you have very few distractions. My desk is over near the water heater, and I like it that way because there's no distractions. The only real noise I ever hear is when the water heater kicks into the furnace. External screen, that is something you may want to look into. Keyboard, mouse, and something else I didn't mention, webcams. Now, usually your laptop will have a webcam built into it, like this one does. So if you want to use Zoom or Skype or whatever it might be, even the Facebook Messenger, use the webcam on here. If you need an external one today, like now, that sits up top of your screen up here, for example, USB one, good luck. They are sold out everywhere and the prices have just gone through the roof. There are good ones out there. My wife has a really good, well, my wife is using mine. And so right now she has it set up in her office upstairs because she works from home. And then we stuck my old green screen behind her. So when she runs Zoom and everything else like that, it's a pretty cool setup, and I think all her coworkers are jealous. Okay, that's all I have to say. If you have any questions on working from home or setting up something like this, hit the comments down below. Hit that thumbs up, thumbs down. I'm easy either way. And I have to go shower. I showered yesterday. Pretty sure I did. I haven't showered yet today. But you know, the day's still early. So enjoy. Talk to you soon. Keep sane. Stop watching the news. The news is just crap. Don't watch the news. Watch something else. You know,
all the streaming channels now are offering like a free 30-day sign up. I think Disney Plus is the only one that's 7 days, but I think everyone else is free 30 days. So sign up for it, enjoy, and set up a VPN, and then you can watch the American channels if you're Canadian. All right, gotta go. Talk to you later. Thanks for watching, and we'll talk soon.